Hello friends, now we are discussing about the difference between the benign and the malignant tumor. What are the differences between the benign and the malignant tumors? First one is the differentiation. Differentiation. The benign tumors are the well differentiated. And the malignant tumors are the undifferentiated or the poorly differentiated. We will discuss about all these terms in next lectures. Now second is the mitosis. In benign tumor, the mitosis rate is low rate, and in malignant tumor it is rapid rate of the mitosis. Next property is the invasion. The invasion is absent in the benign tumors, and it is present in the malignant tumor. Next is metastasis. The metastasis absent in the benign tumor and present in the malignant tumor. In prognosis, we observe local complication in the benign tumor. And in malignant tumor, local plus metastatic complications. Next criteria is the growth rate. The growth rate of the benign tumor is the slow, and of the malignant tumor it is very high. Next is the boundaries of the tissues. The boundaries of the benign tumor is the encapsulated and the well circumscribed. And in malignant tumor it is poorly circumscribed and irregular. Next criteria is the surrounding tissue. In benign tumor, the surrounding tissue are the compressed and in malignant tumor the surrounding tissue are the invaded by the malignant tumor. The size of the benign tumor is the small, and size of the malignant tumor is the larger than the benign tumor. The secondary changes in benign tumor is less, and in malignant tumor is high or more. Now we talk about the differentiation. Differentiation means the extent to which the tumor cell resembles to the tissue of the origin. to which the tumor cell resembles to the tissue of origin. It means the differentiation described at the how much or how little the tumor cells looks like that of the normal cell from which it came. Means the differentiation describes that how much or how little the tumor cell looks like that of a normal cell from which it came. Means the differentiation describes that the how much or how little the tumor cells looks like that of a normal cell from which it came. Well differentiated tumor cells mean well differentiated tumor cells means looks like more normal cell looks more like normal cell and tend to grow and spread slowly grow and spread slowly and the prognosis is good prognosis means the chances of the recovery more in the well differentiated tumor or tissue cell or tissue. How poorly or undifferentiated tumor cells totally different from the normal cell different from normal cell and the growth rate and the spread rate is high. Growth and spread rate is high and the prognosis is the poor prognosis. Now we are talking about the different microscopic features of the malignancy. Malignancy means the presence of the tumor cell or the malignant tumor cell TC. The malignancy may be of the two type, it may be dysplastic or it may be anaplastic. Now we are discussing about the differences between the dysplasia and the anaplasia. At first we talk about the definitions of dysplasia and the anaplasia. Dysplasia means the disordered growth of the tumor cell is known as the dysplasia, and anaplasia means the loss of the differentiation is known as the anaplasia. The loss of the differentiation of the tumor cell is the anaplasia. Second is the proliferation rate. The proliferation rate is high in the dysplasia. High and it is very high in the anaplasia, more than that the dysplasia, very high. And mitotic figure, mitotic figure, the mitotic figure in dysplasia, both are the mitotic figure, typical mitotic figure and the atypical mitotic figure are present. Typical and atypical mitotic figures are present, but the typical mitotic figures are more than the atypical. And typical mitotic figures mean the presence of the two pole. Two pole in the mitotic figures. And in anaplasia there are atypical mitotic figures. Atypical mitotic figures means the mitotic figures are the multipolar or the tripolar. Multipolar or the tripolar. Tripolar or multipolar. Tripolar or the multipolar. Next is the pleomorphism. Pleomorphism. Pleomorphism means the variation in size and shape of the tumor cell. Variation in the size and the shape of the tumor cell is known as the pleomorphism. The pleomorphism present in the dysplasia, present, and it is more present in the anaplasia. It is more in the anaplasia. In normal cell, normal tissue, the cells are arranged like this. And in dysplasia, there is variation in size and shape of these cells. Like this. And in anaplasia, this variation is very high. Like this. Next difference is the nucleocytoplasmic ratio, NC ratio. Nucleocytoplasmic ratio. It is high in the dysplasia and very high in the anaplasia. Very high. In normal cell, the nucleus and the cytoplasm like this, and in dysplasia, the size of the nucleus is increased, and in anaplasia, the size of the nucleus is very high. Very high. The size of the nucleus is increased due to the increment of the nucleoprotein. Due to the nucleoprotein. Nucleoprotein increased. And next difference is the hyperchromatism. Hyperchromatism. The hyperchromatism is seen due to the increased nuclear chromatin and the clumping of the nuclear chromatin. The hyperchromatism presents in the dysplasia, present, but it is more present in the anaplasia. More in the anaplasia. And next is the reversibility. reversibility. The reversibility is partial in the dysplasia, partially, and in anaplasia. Anaplasia is the irreversible. Irreversible. The next criteria is the loss of polarity. Loss of polarity means in normal cell, it is basement membrane and it is nucleus. The nucleus is near to the basement membrane. But in dysplasia, it is away from the basement membrane. And in anaplasia, it is more away from the basement membrane. Like this. The loss of polarity present in the dysplasia and it is more likely present in the anaplasia. These are the difference between the dysplasia and the anaplasia. Now we talk about it. The anaplasia is the hallmark of the malignancy. Anaplasia is a hallmark of malignancy. And we talked that dysplasia, if the dysplasia is present in lower one third epithelium, then it is mild type dysplasia, and it is present in lower, if it is present in lower two third epithelium, then it is severe type of the dysplasia. If it is present in full epithelium, then it leads to carcinoma in situ. Thank you.